Welcome to the benefits and risks of fasting for blood sugar. Are you looking to drop a few pounds or simply get a better grasp on your weight management? Do you wish to take control of your fasting glucose levels and avoid those damaging post-meal blood sugar spikes? Well, doctors are now suggesting that it isn't only about what you eat, but how you eat. New research now suggests that fasting can significantly impact metabolic health, and particularly blood sugar control. But how exactly? And what will these impacts mean for your health? And are there hidden risks associated with not eating? Is fasting really right for you or anyone? Let's find out by exploring the benefits and potential risks of fasting for your weight and your blood sugar. Fasting. It's voluntarily abstaining from consuming any calories for a specified space of time. So, despite the speedy name, fasting is all about going slow, at least when it comes to eating. Intermittent fasting is a new and unique method for creating a schedule of periodic fasting and restricted eating with the goal of losing weight, and in some cases, improving insulin sensitivity. In fact, in recent years, nutritionists, physical fitness experts, and doctors have started to recommend several distinct types of intermittent fasting to type 2 diabetics. But do they actually work? We'll show you if and how intermittent fasting diets may rewire your digestive system and your brain. That's coming up later in this video. But first, it's important to understand the main types of fasting. Luckily, there are a variety of intermittent fasting diets, which can be customized to your preferred schedule. The most basic and perhaps most difficult type of intermittent fasting is the eat-stop-eat method. This 24-hour fasting method involves consuming no food or high-calorie drinks starting after dinner and continuing all the way through the following day, where your first meal will be that evening's dinner. You can also try the 5-2 method. This fasting diet is tailored around consuming a specific amount of calories, just 500 to 600 total calories per day, twice per week. Though it is recommended to avoid doing this 2 days in a row. You can also give it a go with the 16-8 method. In fact, you may already be utilizing this style of fasting without even realizing it. That's because this style involves avoiding eating for 16 hours out of your 24-hour day. But those fasting hours can include your sleep. Essentially, the 16-8 method means that you will keep all of your eating within an 8-hour window. Most people achieve this by simply skipping breakfast and consuming just 2 meals a day, with lunch at noon and dinner no later than 8 p.m. What are the pros and cons of each of these methods? Do any actually give you significant benefits? And which methods might end up hurting your health? That's coming up next. First, please support our channel by hitting the like button, and be sure to subscribe to Diabetes Smarts and ring that notification bell to stay up to date with our latest diabetes fighting content. Okay, so how do each of these types of fasting actually affect your body? And why is the eat-stop-eat method probably not the best choice for diabetics? Let's take a look at intermittent fasting diets, starting with the 16-8 method. Proponents of this method say that, essentially, this intermittent fasting diet naturally forces you to cut back on your daily calorie intake, which will inevitably lead to weight reduction and improved blood sugar. But this type of fasting also works behind the scenes, so to speak, as it can create surprising hormonal changes inside your body. Specifically, research shows that fasting for a long enough time, especially around 16 hours, will create lower levels of insulin, which are released into your bloodstream. This can then lead to increased fat oxidation, Fat oxidation is the process by which your body breaks triglycerides down so they can be used for energy for your muscles. Essentially, it's how your body burns your fat into a source of fuel. In fact, this process can also be achieved through strenuous endurance training. But with the 16-8 method, you can trigger this same process by simply consuming all of your daily calories within an 8-hour window. Fasting, especially the 16-8 hour fast, has been shown to alter the way your body uses energy, and it's all about ketones, acids that are produced by your liver as a result of your body burning its fat, instead of glucose as a source of energy. Ketones are essentially a backup source of fuel for your brain and body when there's not enough glucose available. Intermittent fasting can switch your body into ketosis, which is the process by which your body will begin burning its stored fat. In fact, the keto diet involves avoiding carbohydrates while loading up on fat-rich foods so that your body has little glucose but plenty of fat to burn. But the 16-8 method allows you to maintain a balanced diet while still burning ketones. Now, here's one type of intermittent fasting diet that may clash with your diabetes management. The eat, stop, eat method. Like the 16-8 method, this style of intermittent fasting can create ketosis. But as it turns out, fasting for a 24-hour window twice per week can also lead to potentially dangerous low levels of glucose in your bloodstream, or hypoglycemia. As much as hyperglycemia or high glucose levels can be detrimental to your body, having low levels of glucose in your system can also lead to unwanted side effects, like increased heartbeats, dizziness, anxiety, and for type 1 diabetics, it can lead to other dangerous outcomes. At the same time, if you aren't particularly worried about your blood sugar, but simply wish to drop a few pounds, scientists have suggested that 24-hour fasting windows may be particularly beneficial for fat loss. Participants of this method have reported that it has helped them to lose weight and decrease joint pain. But others say that maintaining the eat-stop-eat method can be quite the chore, as it can create feelings of exhaustion, irritability, and weakness. The 5-2 diet. This form of fasting is probably not as difficult to achieve as regular 24-hour fasts. Though, as you will spend 2 days a week eating less than 600 calories, you can also run the risk of hypoglycemia on this method. But this type of fasting is not all well studied as other forms of intermittent fasting. Still, limited research shows that maintaining a modified alternate day fasting routine, like the 5-2 method, for over 3 weeks can create a 3-8% loss in weight, and a 4-7% reduction in weight circumference. However, new studies show that a modified version of the 5-2 diet, the 4-3 diet, may be of even more benefit. Indeed, some studies now show that the 4-3 method may help to reduce issues like asthma, seasonal allergies, heart arrhythmias, and even insulin resistance. A study published in the journal Nutrition even showed that participants who tried the 4-3 method for 12 weeks experienced an average 11-pound loss in body weight, a 7.7-pound loss in fat mass with no change in muscle mass, a 20% reduction in triglyceride levels, plus reductions in C-reactive protein, which helps to lower inflammation. This study further showed that the 4-3 method can help you increase the size of your LDL cholesterol particles. Don't worry, that's actually a good thing, as smaller particles of LDL cholesterol increase your risk of heart disease. Of course, if you find the 5-2 intermittent fasting diet to be a bit too much or too little, the 4-3 diet may be even more of a challenge, as it essentially means that you spend close to half your week on a very limited calorie count. So, as you can see, there are potential pros and cons to each method, and your personal preferences may determine which style, if any, is best for you. But in general, what have studies really proven about how fasting affects diabetics? Well, let's take a closer look at the scientific data on fasting. First off, while fasting can create ketosis, where your body begins burning its fat stores instead of glucose, you may want to be wary of the keto diet. A recent study from the University Children's Hospital Zurich found that keto diets could interfere with the body's ability to utilize insulin. And thus, this style of eating, where you load up on fatty foods but forgo carbohydrates, may actually lead to increased levels of insulin resistance. But the keto diet is not really considered a fasting diet. On the flip side, maintaining a balanced diet but limiting your eating windows may actually have the opposite effect. In fact, multiple studies have shown that intermittent fasting diet can directly lead to better diabetes management. A US National Library of Medicine study showed that a majority of type 2 diabetic participants who subscribed to short-term intermittent fasting diets lost weight and reduced their insulin resistance. The study further revealed that some participants who did not lose weight still managed to improve their glucose control. Animal trials have demonstrated that fasting helped diabetic mice improve their beta cell function, while also aiding the reconstruction of their healthy gut microbiota. These effects can work to improve blood sugar balance. And in general, scientific data has shown that long-term fasting can help rewire your brain chemistry for suppressing the release of ghrelin, a hormone which can increase feelings of hunger. Research further suggests that long-term fasting may heighten the release of leptin, a hormone which helps you to feel full. So, maintaining an intermittent fasting diet may actually work to reduce your hunger, which, in turn, can lead to a long list of health benefits. In fact, a meta-analysis of multiple studies published in the journal Cell Metabolism found that subscribing to an intermittent fasting diet can reprogram metabolic and stress pathways, which can create several health benefits, and in general, may promote an extended lifespan. Results of animal trials published in this meta-analysis also revealed that intermittent fasting diets helped protect lab mice from heart disease, neurodegeneration, and diabetes. It also led to reductions in blood pressure, rheumatoid arthritis, and obesity. Ramadan fasting, which involves abstaining from food and drink from dawn until sunset for 30 days, has been shown to reduce both post-meal glucose levels as well as long-term blood sugar control. Meanwhile, a study in the journal Cell Press showed that intermittent fasting can decrease internal inflammation, a major benefit for diabetics. Results of one animal study even suggest that alternate day fasting can inhibit oxidative damage, thereby protecting the heart against age-related inflammation and fibrosis. Other studies show that fasting helped lab mice improve their brain structure and brain function, and certain research now suggests that intermittent fasting diets may slow the onset and reduce the severity of Alzheimer's disease. Some studies even indicate that fasting can have positive effects for cancer prevention and cancer treatment. And here's another major benefit of fasting: it can help you to lose weight without losing muscle mass. How does that work? As intermittent fasting diets help you to decrease your body fat, and it can keep your insulin at low levels for most of the day. Both of these changes can lead your body to increase the amount of the chemical human growth hormone, HGH, that is released from your pituitary gland. HGH aids your metabolism, and it also improves your muscle growth and muscle strength. And improving or maintaining muscle mass strengthens the efficiency of your insulin. In fact, studies show that even simply fasting for 24 hours can increase levels of HGH, which, in turn, can aid proper blood sugar regulation and increased insulin sensitivity. So, your preferred method of intermittent fasting may indeed help you to reduce your blood pressure, your body fat, your cholesterol and triglyceride levels, your post-meal blood sugar, and your long-term insulin resistance. However, be sure to talk to your doctor about which style of intermittent fasting, if any, may be right for you before trying it for yourself.